Hey Travis, how are you? Nitzan Mosery here. Welcome for another exciting show of the Traveling Investor Show, where we're going to show you how to master your mind, body, and wallet. And this week, I'm coming at you from Greensboro, North Carolina. If you guys remember last week, we were coming to you from Salt Lake City after spending several weeks in the in Yellowstone and in the Grand Tetons. And now I'm in Greensboro, North Carolina. And you might ask me, well, dude, what are you doing in Greensboro? That's a great question. Well, Greensboro is an emerging market, and we just put a property under contract, an apartment complex, 128-unit multifamily apartment complex that was built in 2001 on the north end of Greensboro, very close to Class A shopping malls. There are apartment complexes that are being built. It is phenomenal. But before this, I was in Boston for several days at my mentor's Ultimate Partnering 2019. Yeah, I'm in a hotel lobby right now called the Biltmore. So you might hear a bunch of people walking in and out and so forth. So I'm not in a studio. I'm actually, this is live. This is here in the Biltmore lobby. And I'm going to show you a little bit about the lobby. But first, I was talking about last week I was in my mentor's Ultimate Partnering event. There were 700 people there. There were speakers. There was networking like you wouldn't believe. It's great going to these events. They happen once a year in Boston, and you just meet such incredible people. You know, it's a great place to network, to build new relationships, but it's also a great place to solidify old relationships, which I did, if I might say, successfully, because there were people there that I've known for years, and we've always been talking about working together and doing stuff together. And I think now it's crystallizing, which is fantastic. And it takes a long time to build these relationships, but once you build them and you harness them and you feed them with honesty and transparency, right, and sincerity, they will flourish and they will grow. Remember, whatever seeds you plant, that's what you will harvest. So we were there, and then from there I went back home. I was in Boca for 2 days, and then I flew here today in the morning. Did the inspection with the property management company, inspectors, and the on-site manager, and I got to tell you, it's been amazing. So this networking event was fantastic. I met some really amazing new people. One person I met, he's going to be on the show later on. His name is Ukee Dozier. He's a former NFL player for the Minnesota Vikings. And when I met him, I said to him, I said, first thing, we got to have you on the show. Why is it that a former NFL player like yourself is looking to get involved in commercial real estate? And we're going to have that conversation with him today. But before we do that, I want you guys to check this out. Look at who's behind me. Either that's Napoleon Bonaparte, or that is, George Washington. But isn't that cool? I want to show you where I'm sitting. That's the beautiful thing about this live video. You can see, check it out. This is where I'm at. Look at this lobby. Isn't this beautiful lobby? Isn't that amazing? So, here I'm sitting in this lobby, a nice hardwood floor, is very old. It's beautiful. Now, I'm going to swing you back here, sitting on these nice plush leather sofas. Check this out. I'm going to swing you around this way so you can see. Look at the fireplace. Isn't that nice? Right, the bookshelf. It's magical here. It's beautiful. I love it. Oops, going that way. Just check it out. Nice seating areas. Very cool spot. Very, very cool spot. It's another one of the things I love about what I do is I get to go and travel and explore and experience all these great places. So I'm going to be sitting here, and for the next 50 minutes, we're going to be talking about mindset, what it takes to become an NFL player, and how that mindset can be translated or transferred to commercial real estate and to becoming successful. Because it doesn't matter what you do, success leaves trails, it leaves hints, but also to become successful, you have to become someone else than you are. You have to become a different person. And that's all in the mindset. So we're going to have a Ukee Dozier come on the phone with us. So it's been fantastic, man. Traveling a lot, you know, was with my family. And now I'm here doing this. It's pretty amazing. I love it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take a short break and we're going to come back. We're going to have Ukee Dozier. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
You're listening to The Traveling Investor on W4CY Radio. Please take a moment to listen to the sponsors who have a secret message just for you. Don't leave. The best is yet to come. The Traveling Investor will be right back. I wanna be rich.
Oh, I wanna be rich. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the Real Yellow Pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a box with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile. Only from AT&T.
Say that again.
This is Rebel Medler. Join me for In Your Face on W4CY.com, Tuesdays at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Fiesta Pet Deli, South Florida's original and only fresh food deli for pets. We carry a full line of products like Bravo, Nature's Variety, and BioComplete. We have FDA-approved meals that are prepared daily. Stop by our brand new store located at Sample Road and the Turnpike in the Festival Flea Market in Pompano, Florida, or call 954-971-2500. Check us out online at www.realfoodforpets.com. If your pet's overweight, suffers from skin problems, or you suspect food allergies, we have the solution. We also carry a large variety of pet strollers, bedding, apparel, collars, leashes, natural chews, and grooming supplies. Veterinarian owned and operated, Fiesta Pet Deli's mission is to help every pet owner have the healthiest pet they possibly can. Call us today for local deliveries or shipping throughout the United States. Call Fiesta Pet Deli today at 954-971-2500. That's 954-971-2500.
You are now tuned into W4CY Radio. Entertainment at your fingertips. I wanna be rich.
Oh, I wanna be rich. Attention listeners, we are preparing once again for takeoff. So please return to your seats as W4CY Radio welcomes back your real estate guru, the traveling investor, Nitzan Mosery.
Hey, travelers, how are you? Nitzan Mosery here, the traveling investor, and I am in Greensboro, North Carolina, and it is fantastic. I'm sitting here at the Biltmore Hotel in Greensboro, in downtown Greensboro. It's about 15 minutes away from the property where I had the inspection today. So that's an awesome property. That's a 2001 property that was constructed in 2001, and it's surrounded by Class A properties, by shopping malls. The Amazon distribution center is about 20 minutes away. It's a great asset to own, you know. And the cool thing is that the owners didn't change any of the appliances hold on a second, guys. I'm getting something here from my engineer. Okay, so maybe that's better. Okay, so what I was saying is the 2001 construction, the owners, or either the current owners or the owners that owned it before these current owners, no one's changed the appliances. No one's changed the cabinets. The countertops, they were they resurfaced. So there's a lot that we can do. We can go in there and we can add value to the property. And that's one of the ways we raise the net operating income, the NOI, the bottom line, the income earned, is by renovating the interior so that we can charge a premium. Okay, so that we can charge a premium. And we're going to go about this in a very systematic way. We have the property management company that's going in there and that's doing it. And it's been fantastic. So, you know, one of the things that you want to make sure that you're doing is when you're doing an inspection is you want to make sure that you walk unit by unit, right? 128 units, walked all of them, walked the one bedrooms, one bath, walked the two bedrooms, two baths. And it's great. So now what I'm going to do tomorrow is I'm going to be walking the comps or driving the comps. I'm going to be driving around looking at all the different properties that are in the area and comparing what they offer at the prices that they have compared to what we have, right? What amenities we have. We have washer dryer hookups. The property also rents the washer dryers, which is great. So there's, you know, it's got a dog park. It's got a car wash. It's got barbecue grills. It's a really nice apartment complex. I'm very, very excited about this. Tomorrow we're going to complete the due diligence and then they're going to put the all the reports together. They're going to send it to us, and then my team and I, we will go over everything. We'll go over all the, we'll go over what they had to say about the leases. We'll check the way the leases are staggered for the expiration date, and if there's any issues, we'll confront it at that point. Construction problems, if there are any. We've got the plumber that's going to be out there, electrician, the roofer. I went into all the units. They're, you know, it's amazing. The ones, a majority of the units, people kept them really nice. You got a few people that, you know, hoarders or, you know, do things differently. But majority of the units on the inside were just fantastic. I am super, super excited for this property. It's going to be a very good asset to have in our portfolio. So let's talk now about, you know, networking, right? I said I was at this networking event that my mentor put on, and he puts it on every year in the summertime. It's called Ultimate Partnering. It's by RE Mentor. You should check it out. It's called Ultimate Partnering. So next year it'll be Ultimate Partnering 2020, and it's going to be in Boston, and it's going to be awesome. So I suggest you go. And when you check rementor.com and you want to go, mention my name. Mention Nitzan Mosri. Say, hey, Nitzan Mosri sent us. So they know where you came from. But networking. You know, I was there and I took away two pieces of information. You know, two aha moments. One aha moment is, you know, I mentioned it in my intro, is networking. Never stop networking, even the people that you know. And if it's an event that you've been going to and you've seen the same people over and over again, continue to go. This is how relationships are built. This is how business is done. I've had people come up to me at this last event and say, hey, Nitzan, you know, I want to invest with you. I want to do business with you. Let's make it happen, and so forth. It really, really exciting when that happens, right? Because that is the seed that you've planted now popping up, and now we're able to, you know, it's sprouting, and now we're able to harvest it, harvest that relationship, and it's fantastic. So network, you know, and plus the people that I met, the new people that I met, it really is amazing to see how many people want to get involved in multifamily because they understand, hey, you know what? It's all about passive recurring income. It's about buying a property once, putting the management in, putting the systems in place, using the systems, and then letting that property feed you for years and years and years. It's a beautiful thing. And a lot of people are getting involved, and a lot of people want to get educated properly. So RE Mentor has great education. Okay, they taught me. But you know what? Everybody gets the same education, but not everybody becomes successful. So there are a couple of things that differentiate people who are successful from those who aren't, right? Jim Rohn said it best. He said, you know, the winds of opportunity all blow on us the same way. It's how we set our sails that determines our destination. And I think that is phenomenal, especially someone like myself who I love sailing. I got my skipper's license, so I totally get it, right? If you ever watch the sailing regattas, the races, you can see one guy is catching the wind and the other guy's just a little bit off of his tail on the back, just on the side, but he's not quite catching it because you know what? That wind is blowing with everybody, but the guy in front just knows how to tackle it properly. He knows how to set his sails just a little bit tighter, just a little bit, you know, a little bit more into the wind and really find it. So it all depends on how you have your sails, right? And in this business, the sails could mean many different things, right? It could be your mindset, right? It could be your team. It could be all this. It could be your passion, your desire. This is what separates the successful students from the non-successful students, from the students that will go to an event, go to a boot camp, they'll get all the information, they'll get excited, they'll go home Sunday night, they'll put the books on the shelf, they'll get all excited, come Monday, they'll wake up and they will continue their life as if nothing has happened. Then you've got other people that go out and they get educated, and then they go out and they implement what they learned step by step by step. And that is why it's so key to have a mentor, to have a coach, to have someone who can hold you accountable, who can be a sounding board, and who can also guide you and show you where the pitfalls are, you know, talk to you about what you're doing and be a guide for you. It's so crucial for your success. But the one thing that you need to have to differentiate between you and anybody else is how hungry are you? How hungry are you? That's the one thing that differentiates the Elon Musks from the people on the street over here walking down. That's the one thing that differentiates, you know, Jeff Bezos from Amazon from anybody else walking down the street. Their hunger. They were hungry. They didn't let anything stand in their way. They saw their goal. They said, I don't care how we're going to do it. I have no idea how we're going to do it. We're going to do it. We're going to figure it out, and we're going to show everybody. And they didn't stop. They didn't stop. They were hungry. And if you're hungry enough, you will figure out the how. So that hunger can also be translated as your why. Why are you doing this? Why do you want to be successful? Why do you want to go through all the obstacles, through all the ups and downs, through the emotions, through the heart-wrenching days, through the highs and the lows? Why do you want to do that? Why not just get a job and enjoy yourself for the next 30, 40 years and then get a pension and, you know, retire on some rock somewhere? Why? Why is it that you want to be successful? When we come back, we're going to dive into that a little bit more. So stay tuned. A word from our sponsors, and we'll be right back.
Investor on W4CY Radio. Please take a moment to listen to the sponsors who have a secret message just for you. Don't leave. The best is yet to come. The Traveling Investor will be right back.
Hey, everyone. I'm Jimmy Starr, the King of Cool, and your host of the Jimmy Starr Show. The entertainment radio show for all you cool and unique people looking to get a behind-the-scenes peek at what's going on in the entertainment industry. Listen in as me and my cool crowd of co-hosts bring you celebrity guests, new music, and the good times in fashion, entertainment, and pop culture. Right, everybody?
There we go.
Tune in live Wednesdays at 3 p.m. Eastern on W4CY.com.
What's happening, Ukee?
Oh man, good, good.
You got the best.
Awesome.
Your favorite internet radio station.
So, we're going to talk about NFL.
What it's like. We have all the entertainment you desire, from talk to music to comedy, right here at W4CY.com. Listen to W4CY Radio 24/7 for giveaways, exciting contests, and fun. Informational, motivational, entertaining, interactive. It's W4CY.com.
Saturday night.
You get home okay?
You know exactly what sun and water. Every flower needs an
apartment.
You know when someone's
back, and we picked up our baby girl.
we can help you find more people to find. And by working together, we
just
can
just finish the tie with her. At well, I had to get back to work. Now I'm back to work. Obviously, sitting in my office doing my
online, mobile, and direct marketing. AT&T Advertising Solutions has local advertising experts to help your small business find more customers. Call 1-800-GET-REAL to learn more. AT&T, rethink possible.
Beautiful property.
Attention listeners, we are preparing once again for takeoff. So please return your seats as W4CY Radio welcomes back your real estate guru, the traveling investor, Nitzan Mosery.
Hey, travelers, how are you? Nitzan Mosery here, the traveling investor. Welcome back. And, you know, as I mentioned earlier, when I was in Boston, I met some incredible people. And, you know, as soon as I meet incredible people, I just jump on them and I say, hey, I need to have you on my show. And of course, who do I bump into? But I bump into former NFL Viking, Minnesota Vikings player, Ukee Dozier. And thank you so much, Ukee, for being on the show. I know you're super busy. You've got a little baby girl. You're working. You got your whole life. And I appreciate you taking the time out, sharing with me and all the travelers out there about mindset and all that. So, hey, man, thanks for being on the show.
Oh, thanks for having me. Thanks for having me.
So, you know what? Let's just get into it. So, you know, you and I met in Boston, right? We were at a commercial real estate conference. What's an NFL player doing looking at commercial real estate?
See, that's a good question. And I think, you know, what it kind of boils down to is being able to explore new opportunities. So what typically happens with a lot of NFL players is if they don't have the specific guidance, you talk about financial literacy is kind of a big thing. A lot of times, you know, they take their money and they want to spend it on things that depreciate in value, right? For me, you know, my mindset has been a little different. I think that's more so because of the people that I've kind of gravitated to, the people who've kind of helped mold and mentor me throughout my years beyond football. They wanted me to really place a lot more focus on things that are going to build wealth. Not things that's going to take it away, but things that are going to specifically build wealth. And I kind of fell into real estate once before. I remember when I was playing ball, I purchased my first piece of property. It just so happens that property, when I purchased it, this was right before, you know, the whole, you know, 2006 thing. But it gave me a taste of, you know, home ownership. And then from that point on, I ended up purchasing a couple of more properties over the past few years. One has been a duplex and another single family home where I got to the I started to rent those properties out and I saw just the cash flow. When I started really understanding that, you know, all right, I have these properties that, you know, specifically these are my debt payments, but I can rent them out for more than what my debt payments are. I receive cash flow from it. I mean, why wouldn't I do that? Why wouldn't I do that, you know, on a bigger scale? So from that point on, I took it as though, you know what, I see all of these multifamily properties, all these different developmental properties that are starting to grow up, especially in my area in Minneapolis. Minneapolis is a big metropolitan city. It's continuous growth, it's continuous redevelopment. So seeing those opportunities, my main focus from then on was like, well, how can I scale up from what I've been doing before? How can I go from the single family to the duplex to the, you know, the 10 unit, the 100 units to the 150 units, you know, or beyond. So that's been my mindset kind of based off it. You know, it kind of started from the ground floor, but now I'm thinking more big picture. And that's what I'm trying to get to.
That's awesome. And, you know, you mentioned a couple of things that I want to hit on. You mentioned having mentors, right? You said the mentors that teach financial literacy, and that is so important. Those two things, right? First of all, you got to have a mentor, right? You got to have someone who is willing to help you, is willing to show you the ropes, is willing to guide you and to be there, right? When you have questions and doubts and you don't know where to go and whatnot. But the second thing is to have a mentor that will teach you about financial literacy is so important, because we see a lot of the NFL players, right? They get injured or they stop playing, right? They retire. And then a couple of years later, they're flat broke because, like you said, they go out and they buy the depreciating assets rather than the appreciating assets. And next thing you know, they're flat broke because they've just been spending, spending, spending. So having that mentor to teach you financial literacy is huge, is huge. And understanding the fact that you can buy something and have other people pay your mortgage. And if there's a little bit left, you know, you get to pay your electric bill with that.
Of course, of course. And I think it's all about understanding the concept of leverage, right? You know, being able, you can talk about use other people's money, but also think about just from a debt standpoint. Yeah, if I can, let's say, for instance, if I have $1 million, right? You know, I signed a contract as an NFL player. We go, let's say, for instance, I go to the playoffs and I receive another $1 million bonus on top of what I've earned. How about I just take that extra $1 million and leverage it with some debt in order to purchase a property, let's say, three times the amount of money that I made. Right. So next thing I have a property that, you know, it's a $3 million property. I put up $1 million. I have a debt service for another $2 million, $2 point whatever, but I'm receiving cash flow off of that, right? It's all about having that residual income that comes from it, because realistically, as an NFL player, your earnings potential is only relevant while you're on the field. You know, once you're off the field, you're not earning any more money. How are you going to earn money? A lot of these guys, I'm not saying all of them, but some of these guys, they don't have college degrees, you know, because they leave to go earlier to the NFL. Or it's been all about football, or the focus has always been about the sport that they don't know how to do anything else. So that transition from life after football is rough for a lot of people because they don't know. They don't know what else to do but football. Right. So I'm looking at it as an opportunity, not just for myself, but an opportunity to kind of help bring along some of the people who have kind of, you know, shed blood, sweat and tears throughout the process. I just want to be able to be a mentor for them as well. Obviously, I'm being mentored along the way, but I want to be able to give off my knowledge and my wealth that I'm getting from this venture of mine. And being able to apply it to others as well. So that's kind of like my big picture on that as well.
Sure, absolutely. Sure. You know, it's all about giving back. It's all about helping people. You know, the great master was asked one day by the students, you know, master, how does one become, you know, a master? How does one become wealthy? And they said, you know, by servicing others, being of service to others. Right? So more people we help, the more people we help achieve success, then the more success will be brought on to us. It's just, you know, it's just the way the universe works, right? So let's talk real quick about mindset, right? Mm-hmm. What kind of mindset does an NFL player have when they're on the field? I mean, first of all, what is it like to be on a field with a full stadium and everybody's yelling and freaking out? That must be amazing. Right. That feeling must be awesome.
Right. No, I mean, it's an exhilarating feeling. When you hear, you know, let's say 70 to 100,000 people in the stands, you know, just screaming and yelling. It's funny because this kind of goes back to college as well. I remember my first time playing in a stadium where it was over 100,000 fans. We talk about Michigan. We talk about the Penn States, the Ohio States. I remember literally talking to one of my teammates, trying to yell at him, and I couldn't even hear myself yell. It was so loud. But the funny thing is as the plays go on, a lot of times your brain has its way of just kind of dulling out of the sound, right? You don't hear it until after the play is over. But during the play, you don't hear anything. It's nothing but complete focus. Nothing but complete focus on what you need to get done. And you talk about that mindset is realistically understanding, like, what is the job at hand? You know, what's the overall goal? What are we trying to accomplish when I set foot on this field, just like in life? But what am I trying to accomplish when I get to this point? I'm on the field, I'm between the lines, I'm in the field of play. The whistle is blown. It's time to get ready and go, right? You have to be able to kind of filter out everything that's going on. You might have things that go on in life that might deal with you, that might bring you down, might depress you in whatever kind of way. But you have to find a way to kind of filter out all of that noise in order to focus on that one specific play, or focus on that one specific drive, or focus on that one specific assignment that you have, and being able to execute. So
yeah, it's very zen.
Yes,
when
it is.
When you put it that way, right? Yeah. Because when you're in meditation, when you're in the now, when you are fully present, you're not thinking of anything else. You're not thinking of your spouse, of your kids, of your parents, of your siblings. You're not thinking about yesterday. You're not thinking about tomorrow. You're not thinking about anything else, but you are fully in that moment, right? So you're standing there. You got to hear the quarterback. You got to hear everything. And like you said, you filter everything out, and then that silence just overtakes you, and the focus. And you know, it's funny that you say that, because, you know, it's like that, I think, with anything else. When you want to be successful in anything, being an athlete in the NFL or being a real estate investor or anything, you really have to focus your energy on what you're doing at that particular moment, right? Whether it be with your relationships, with your spouse, with your children, with your coworkers, with friends, whenever you're there, you know, we need to be present, right? A lot of, you know, we have this technology, the phones now, and everybody's, you know, on their phones, and you know, you could have five people sitting next to you, nobody saying a word, but they're all over the place, right? One's looking in China, one's looking over here, one's looking over there, and everybody's doing their own thing, but nobody's present in the present moment. And that, I think, that's what differentiates the players, whether it be on the football field or you know, in the closing tables, right?
Right.
What differentiates the winners from those who have a hard time is the focus, wouldn't you say?
Of course. Of course. I mean, that's kind of been the thing with any and everybody that I've noticed that have got to a certain point and then failed because they allowed outside influences or outside situations to kind of come and take over and retract their mind, their thought processes, you know. And again, you talk about focus. Focus is most important. You know, you set out for one specific thing. You have to focus on it. If you don't focus on it, that allows the enemy or the adversary to come in and change your thought process from where you wanted to be to where they wanted to be, you know. So, yeah, of course.
Absolutely. Now let me ask you this. When we met in Boston, you had told me that you weren't drafted, but you came on, right?
Yep, I was undrafted.
So you probably had to go through a lot more than someone who was drafted to get picked for the team.
Of course.
What would you say was the one, two, or three things that put you over the top that they said yes? I mean, talent, right? Talent is one. You got to have talent, right? Doesn't matter what you do. You got to have some sort of talent, right? But what was it above the talent that they saw in you that they said, we want Ukee?
You know what? You talk about talent, and the funny thing is, when I got to the NFL, I realized that the talent levels weren't that different. Once you're there, everybody essentially is close to the same level of talent. The thing that differentiates people when they get to that point is want to. It's who wants to do whatever it takes to make this team. You know, so it takes a lot of sacrifice, a lot of sacrifice. Primarily, it's a lot more sacrifice on your body than anything else, because you're wanting to make a first impression, right? You want to make not just a first impression, but a lasting impression. On all you need is really one person on that team, one person on that coaching staff to say, I really like that kid, you know, and it takes really having to retrain your mind and kind of really more so brainwash yourself in a sense that where you're saying that I'm going to give 110% every time I step foot out here. I'm going to throw my body around. I'm going to give it all so that when I walk off this field during practice time, when I walk off this practice field, I have nothing left in the tank. I have to get in the ice tub immediately and replenish myself, because You have to have yourself in that mindset, because what's going to happen essentially, especially as an undrafted guy, undrafted free agents, you're looking to be weeded out, right? They want to weed you out early. You have to be the one that sticks around. You have to be the one that says, no, coach, I'm not going nowhere. I'm showing you that I belong here, and I'm going to show you that through my play. I'm going to show you that through my effort. And I'm just going to really dig and fight. So, yep, that's essentially what happened. That was my story. That was my story realistically, because, you know, I came in again. You talk about we haven't, you know, had a good draft class. It was a good draft class that came in that year. It was a coaching.
What year did you join?
So that was 2005. Mm-hmm. 2005. So they had some decent draft picks that came in that year. For me, you know, coming in the training camp, I actually came into training camp late, because when I first came in, I signed with Tampa because I'm originally from Florida. I wanted to play at home, wanted to play in front of my close friends, my family. That's where I wanted to be, but things didn't work out there. So I ended up coming to Minnesota. I want to say during the first week of camp. So I'm already behind the eight ball. Mm-hmm. I'm already behind on everything else, right? I don't know the playbook. I don't know what coaches or how they were looking at some of the players that were already there. All I knew is I had to do whatever it takes to leave a lasting impression on my coach, as well as the special teams coach, and the head coach as well. You know, so I remember my first shot, the first preseason game. My rookie year, first preseason game, I didn't even play. And that was more so because I was so new. I was new and, you know, they weren't comfortable with just putting it in. Plus, they had some other guys they didn't want to see because, again, we had a fresh crop of young guys. So they wanted to test them out at first. And I remember game two, we were in New York. We went to play the New York Jets. And they gave me an opportunity to run down on kickoff. And I remember the first kickoff I ran down, it was a full head of steam. Full head of steam. I saw nothing but a hole open wide open with the returner coming straight through. I threw all of the 200 pounds that I was holding at the time. I threw everything into him. I remember jumping up and running back to the sideline, everybody giving me a high five. And that was the first impression that I needed for them to say, you know what, I think this kid is going to do something. So from that point on, I remember the next week, and then I was starting. I was starting on the special teams unit coming the following week, all because of that one play. All because of that one play where I said to myself, you know what, forget everything else, I'm going to give it all. And whatever happens from there, that happens, right? It's I didn't want to regret my opportunity. I wanted to take full advantage of that opportunity that was presented to me. I didn't want to have any regrets. So I left it all on the field that day.
That's beautiful. That's a great story. That's a great story. And you know, it equates to getting started in multifamily, right? Mm-hmm. You mentioned a lot of things, right? Once you got there, everybody had basically the same talent, right? But you had to prove yourself. You had to show, let's say, for lack of a better word, right, the coaches or the sponsors of the deal, right, what you're capable of, right?
Right.
You went onto a team that already has all the players and everything, the structure, the systems already built in, and you placed yourself into that team and you made yourself a known figure. So it's the same thing as, you know, a lot of newbies getting started in real estate, right? They don't know where to go. They don't know what to do. They come to us, for example, say, hey, I put this property in the contract, right? Which is like you walking onto the field, right? Saying, you know, I don't know anything. I'm here though. Watch what I can do. I put this property under contract. It's like you running down the field, right? Doing that first impression. And then they say, listen, we don't know what else to do, right? Show us, guide us, right? Mentor us, which is what you were mentioning also, right? You have your coaches that tweak you, right? That take you from here and they take you to 11. It has all of the same kind of, you know, atmosphere and components put into it, right? You gotta, you know, and the one thing that you said is that hunger, right? What separates? Mm-hmm. What separates the people that start, right? Mm-hmm. The people that get sent home and saying, you know what, you know, thanks for playing, but you know, here's a couple of free season passes, you know, you can come check us out, right? It's that hunger. How hungry are you, right? You were hungry to get on that team, right? You were hungry to make an impression. You said to yourself, I am giving it all and there's nothing else. And that's kind of, you know, I'm not taking away from what you did. You know, you were going, you know, being on an NFL football field and whatnot is mind blowing. I'm sure, you know, every American would love to be where you are, right? But doing whatever it takes, right? My partner and I, we have that same philosophy when we put properties under contract or when we're working on projects with our investors and so forth. We will do whatever it takes to get the job done, right? Mm-hmm. There is no, you know, you can't tell us no, we'll find a way. And you met my business partner this weekend. You saw how,
yeah.
how determined she is,
of
right?
Of course.
You know, so it's the same thing, right? When you're getting involved in real estate investing, and you know you're gonna have your ups and downs, right? You're gonna get your ass kicked, right? You're gonna get knocked down. You're gonna have somebody like you charging at you 200 pounds that is just gonna lay you flat on the floor, right? And that could be anywhere from, you know, having your money go non-refundable and then finding issues on the property, right? You just get smacked. You don't know what to do. So you got to be able to stand up, you know, shrug it all off and be like, all right, next play. What are we doing? Let's move forward, right?
Mm-hmm.
So,
of course.
So what is it that let me rephrase this. You started buying single. You started buying real estate. You went into the duplex. You know, like in football, you need to learn the plays, right? You need to learn the playbook, right?
Right.
When did you realize that you needed a playbook for commercial real estate?
You know, I think when I realized that, for one, you talk about just from a monetary standpoint, right? I'm like, okay, well, if I'm looking to do a, let's say, for instance, a 100-unit property, I know that a 100-unit property is going to run me roughly $5.5 million. You know, I'm thinking about it this way now. Well, if I'm having to raise money for this property, I started thinking more like from an investment standpoint, SEC and following compliance. How can I be compliant, for one, right? So that's when I started doing a lot more research. If I need to be compliant, that means I have to have an SEC attorney. I have to go through syndications, things of that sort. I'm like, well, how do I do that? I've never done that before. I can raise the money, but I need to make sure that I need to be as compliant as possible. I want to make sure that I want to be as professional as possible, because essentially when you're dealing with other people's money, you want to make sure that you want to be credible, right? You want to have all the credibility, and professionalism. You have to be credible and professional when dealing with other people's money, because if not, they're only going to give you one chance. It's just like in football. You get one chance to make that first impression. And the same process for me is more so understanding that I have an opportunity. I want to make sure that I know everything that I need in order to take advantage of this opportunity, because if not, that one chance might be the only chance that I get. So that's when I realized, as though if I'm going to do this, I have to make sure I have people that's going to help walk me along the way, people that's going to help mentor me and guide me, just in case if I have any hiccups and whatever the issues may be. I want to make sure that regardless of the fact, I am being, I'm a great steward of one, my investors, but also I'm being a great student for myself.
Sure. Let me ask you, when you were in the NFL, did you guys, as a team or individual players, ever set goals for yourselves?
Yeah, I think everybody set goals. You know, typically, you know, as a team, you know, there's always an end goal. The team wants to, you know, you want to be the one that's standing there on the podium raising the Lombardi Trophy. But also individually, I think as any not just a professional athlete, I think as an athlete in general, if you're really focused on your sport and your craft, you know that you want it. If you start the season at this level, you know you want to end the season at another level. You want to always increase yourself. I hear the term, a lot of people use it. I don't like to bite off anybody else, but they always say, you know, 1%, right? You want to get 1% better each and every day. That's something that you should strive for, right? If you're getting 1% better each and every day, even though it's a small increment, small increments add up along the way. So it's just like anything else. You know, you start in a training camp, you know you want to get better from day one to the end of training camp, but you also know at the end of training or at the start of the season, you want to be better than what you were at the end of the season. And I think that's in everything that we do. That translates, and that's a good thing about football, not football, but just sports in general, because you talk about from a developmental standpoint, sports, you know, this definitely has developed me. And I see how it develops others as well. It's all about growth. It's all about constant growth and being able to just take whatever you learn and just kind of apply it everywhere else. So, yes.
That's beautiful. I totally agree with you. It's all about the growth, right? Success is not the financial aspect to it, but success is the person that you become while achieving that success.
Yeah, of course.
We have to become something greater than we are to be able to achieve greatness.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, Ukee, we've got our last minute here. Is there any last minute advice that you can give our travelers? We got 1 minute left. You know, that are starting out in commercial real estate, that are, you know, looking into new careers. What's one thing that you could tell
them? I would say to eliminate hesitation. Typically, when you hesitate, and that's you're breeding fear, you're allowing other thoughts to come into your mind that's going to create self-doubt in whatever it is that you're trying to do. What you want to do is essentially you want to, again, everybody wants to have articulated plans as to what they want to do. Sometimes you just have to step out on faith. You have to step out on faith and just give it a chance, because I feel like if you fall or you fail, typically if you're moving forward, you're going to fall forward, right? Meaning you're making progress. So, you know, all the successful people, all the successful businessmen that I know of, that I've been around, they failed at something. They failed in a lot of different things, but only way they failed only because they were trying to do whatever they want to do. So, my two cents is really just reach for the stars. If it's something that you want to do, move forward towards that goal. If you stumble along the way, that's fine. Stumbling means growth.
Ukee, thank you so much for being on the show. Ukee Dozier, former NFL Minnesota Vikings cornerback, correct?
Cornerback, yes.
Cornerback, awesome. Not newbie, but sort of getting started in the commercial real estate world. Thank you so much for being on the show. I really, really appreciate you having you here. Travelers, I want to leave you with this last thing, this last saying. May the road rise up to meet you. May the sunshine fall upon your face. And may the rains fall softly upon your fields. Until the next time, this is the Traveling Investor. I'll see you next week somewhere on Spaceship Earth. Take care. Thanks, Ukee.
Appreciate it. Have a good one.
Wow, what a great show. Are you excited to learn the untold secrets of how to get wealthy? Then tune in next Thursday and every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern right here on W4CY Radio. You too can learn how to become a traveling investor. If you missed any part of this episode or want to hear it again, go to the Traveling Investor Podcast on iHeartRadio. You can listen to all past episodes on demand 24/7. Next week's episode will take us somewhere new and exciting, so don't miss it. Thank you for listening.